host Kendra. I am back every week with you. But today I have two of your favorites, Callie and Kai. So we're going to be talking about free time because this is the season finale and we're going to have a little break before I start season two. So I'm going to have some free time. And I want to talk about what free time looks like for you as a mom. So like, y'all know, I went out last night.
Spending your free time.
Spending my free time out before the school year starts and my kids come back like full time at my house. And I had too much fun. And honestly, like, we're going to have to, we should roll, I need the, like, to roll, like, the video, like, the montage of everything that I did last night, like, da, 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 because that's how it was.
That's how it was.
Right. It was lit. Girl, but, it was. We all should go to JoJo's Beloved. Well, so what do y'all do in your free time?
Well, for me, what I do in my free time, I'm back in the gym now.
Yay!
I just told y'all the little funny. My child tried to play me, so I'm back in the gym now. I'm thinking about getting my master's or switching careers altogether.
What are you gonna switch to?
Lately, right now, I've been thinking about going into nursing. But
that's okay. You know what? That was kind of your original joint,
exactly,
though.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. But it's just kind of like right now with her dad coming out the road, the truck, and he's a truck driver. So
right. We
all know.
Right.
So that's kind of taking up my free time. Sucks to suck. Not really suck to suck, but like to say my free time is being a mom too. Because like I love having fun with her.
Mm-hmm.
So like we're making pizzas, we're making ices, we're outside in her her house that we got her for Christmas. We're on the bikes. We try to go to the park. So like my free time includes her too.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes. But like when I don't have her, I'm probably just chilling, scrolling, which I need to do a social media fast. Scrolling, trying to get back into reading because that was something I loved doing. So, really, my free time is kind of all over the place. Whatever I feel like doing in that moment, whether it's going to get my toes done, scrolling, mm-hmm. watching TV, washing clothes, or just doing something with her, is just kind of like, that's me. That's what I'm doing.
So, for me, being a stay-at-home mom and being with my kids all the time, my free time, as y'all know, started going to the gym.
Yeah,
been going to the gym consistently for about 6 months now.
Has it been that long?
It's been
okay,
6 months.
Wow.
So yeah, and I really like that because every day my husband get off work, I get to go to the gym.
Yeah.
So I use that time that I have, even if it's 2 hours, I'll take it.
Yeah.
I started getting back in read. I started getting back into reading again.
Wow, who gave you that book?
So my friend Kendra gave me a book and popped it off. And so I started buying more books. So I think I'm on like book 4 now. And I tried to read 4 books by July. And then August 1st, I'm going to start over. Because I kind of started at the end of July with the whole reading. As far as that, you know, being with the kids because I'm with them all the time. I'm still trying to figure out things that I like to do after being pregnant. Because if you know me, I was pregnant back to back. So it's like... I done been pregnant on 2 of my birthdays, so I haven't really, you know, had time to, like, you know, figure things out, do new things that I want to do.
You got a birthday coming up.
So, yeah.
Got to plan that.
Yeah, so doing? I've been thinking about it. I just don't know yet just because, you know, free time.
Yeah.
Kids, I got to make sure, you know, I have 3 kids now, so it's a lot easier to move around one child to a family versus 3 of them.
Yeah.
And then one of them's still a baby. So, but, you know, either way, for my birthday, y'all know about it. So, right now, I just feel like I'm turning into this gym girl, and I just really like that
gym
for myself.
Life.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Gym is
y'all need to go to the gym.
Immediately.
Everybody go to the gym. It solves all problems.
It really does. I had somebody tell me that just people who be in a gym looking for people.
I don't even see nobody in
myself.
The gym.
Really?
Like,
that's
when
what
I
was saying.
I don't even, like, when them headphones come on, mm-hmm. I don't see y'all.
I do.
Right. Like, I just
see you.
I don't even know what's going on.
What?
I be so zoned out, especially when I got that mirror space in front of me.
Yes. I don't see. I'm John Cena. Y'all can't
see
me. Man.
Because,
baby.
Right. I see a dude at the front when I scan my card.
When the towels ain't out.
Yes. Now, when the gym ain't got them towels, I'm mad. Now I see everybody.
Yeah, right. Where are the towels?
Where are the towels? Right. Why are they not in here? Because
as a member,
I need fresh towels out so I can wipe down my machine.
Period.
So I don't get staph infection.
I thought that's right. Period.
I be so mad. Yeah. Where's
that
the
person who said that? Gotta be crazy.
Gotta be crazy.
Gotta be slow.
Let your girl go to the gym.
I figured that.
Yeah, your girl gonna feel better and she gonna look better after the gym.
Period.
You can't beat those two. Feel better and look better.
That's a win-win. Feel good, look good, play good. Look good, feel good, play good.
The gym, y'all.
That's right.
Go for a walk. Move every day.
Gym literally is life. Yes. But they also say people who go to the gym, that is their life. Like, that's their personality.
Yeah.
It is. I'm sorry.
What's the problem?
I would say, like, it's a part of my personality. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Yeah. It is something that, like, when people ask me to tell them about me, I will say that.
Right.
Astrology comes first.
Right.
Then gym for me.
Yeah, right. You know, Kendra, you definitely know astrology and then gym. Yeah.
Astrology first, then gym.
Because I feel like for me, gym is my life right now because I'm just kind of getting, I got through like my whole postpartum, being pregnant back to back, that postpartum hit a little harder this time.
Yeah.
And so I'm like, I'm just getting out. But I'm about to find some more hobbies to do.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
For sure. You have to.
Yeah.
You have to.
Yeah. Especially like, I feel you on the postpartum being pregnant because, you know, Sam and Weston ain't but like 20 months apart. So I did that too. See.
Yeah, that postpartum hit.
That too.
Back to back.
It's rough because it really comes in like waves.
Yes.
Like, okay, I'm getting back to me. Oh, I'm pregnant again.
Yeah, yep.
Like, and then after you had a baby, you'd be like, okay, I'm going to get back to me.
Mm-hmm.
But then you got the little baby.
You got a baby and that toddler.
Yeah.
And it's like,
baby and the toddler.
They still need me 100% right now. So I got to push me to the side just for a little bit. Mm-hmm. But I'm coming back.
The good thing was, I think for me at the time when I had them, like, their dad is a reformed, I guess, professional athlete, whatever, and he used to train me in the garage, so we did used to work out in the garage.
Right, like, so you still got, you know,
so,
to
like,
move.
That's why I be telling people, no, I actually do know how to fight, like, I just,
right.
No, actually, don't play with me.
Right.
I'm just not trying to fight y'all.
Right, actually, but I would just rather go home. Like,
right,
so,
exactly.
Like,
I got two people to live for.
Mm-hmm.
I'm finna go home because sending jail is not an option.
No.
Because I'm going to have to go to jail.
Yeah.
The way I'm finna fight.
Yes.
At this point,
like,
leave me alone.
I don't do none of that. I do love to go get, like, I love to go get my toes done, my nails done, my eyebrows. Like, that maintenance
day.
Yeah.
That fresh set hit
needed.
So hard.
It's
oh, my
needed.
God.
It's needed because it really puts, like, you getting your body together. Now that physical.
Yes.
Your nails look good.
Exactly.
Your feet look good. You wet.
The wax, we were ready and prepped.
I'd be in a better mood altogether when I leave the wax.
Yes.
I just feel lighter.
It's because it's like one less thing you don't have to worry about.
Yeah.
The air.
For sure. Does.
A little breeze.
Breathing.
Yes, those maintenance days.
Yeah.
Yeah, the maintenance days be the days. And like, that's, I think, as a mom, I think it's so hard sometimes to find that free time, especially like as a single parent, even as a married mother, like it's still hard because it's like kids, kids.
Either way.
And then like if you work it and work on top of that, you stay home, so you ain't never not working.
Yeah, you never always working.
And so like it's a little different, you know?
Right,
what I mean?
Yeah.
It's hard to find the free time, but I think it's so important. Like, and I think it all started for me when I was pregnant with Sam, and the first, like, the best piece of advice that somebody gave me was to sleep when he sleeps. And they were like, don't be up trying to fold clothes.
It's hard.
It is hard. Because it's like, dang,
when am I going to do it?
Exactly. Yeah. You want to be held. Now I got to fold clothes, but girl. Yeah.
And, like, that's when I really started being like, oh, I'm really about to have to plan my free time.
Yeah, for real.
Because, like, literally, I have to sleep when this baby sleep, but I still got stuff that I got to do at the house.
Yeah.
But I still do need that free time.
Right, yeah.
But it'd be so hard because some women are like, no, I can keep going. I'm like, no,
you cannot.
Because I tried.
No, you cannot.
And it was just like, okay, Kyle, you cannot do everything.
Yeah.
It's really hard to do that. You have to, like, have that free time. As a parent, as a mother, like, you gotta have
that
you time
have to.
For yourself.
Kids will run you down.
Because they will run you down. Yes. They love you to death.
Yes. Right. But all the energy is just like, you're not tired.
Yeah.
Like, you don't want to sit down.
We had this same conversation during last time I was here, and I was like, I feel bad, but like, I can feel the shift. Like, if Mackenzie is on me all day, I'm like, girl, you don't go. And I'm like, okay, wait. She just four. Take a step back.
Yep.
try to figure out where you're going to get that free time, or just think about the next time you're going to get your free time, because it's like, it's not her fault. She ain't asked to be here.
Exactly. So like, okay, all she knows
let me,
you.
Exactly. Yeah. Let me take my emotion out of it and be like, okay.
Right.
Let me call somebody and take care real quick for a day, like just for the night, just so I could either stay up if I want to or go to sleep, you know, do whatever that I feel like doing in that moment. And my family is really good about that.
That's good.
Will help. If I call my cousins or any of them, because, again, her dad is on the road, so, like, they'll come. And even him, like, he plans on coming home at the end of next month, August. And he's like, huh, I got you, da-da-da, whatever. I'm like,
that's good.
I mean, I'm a parent. But right. I also appreciate it, too, because you going to need your free time. Yeah, you a dad, but, like, it's going to be the exact same way. You're going to be home. You already feeling like you want to help me so much, but you're going to need that free time. So I'm excited for him to come home so we can kind of plan around that. Mm-hmm. But, you know, maybe if my friend will invite me out, you know, I might have a little bit more free time. We'll see. Had to throw that in there, a little shade.
They're throwing shade at me. these are my OG, tried and true, like 10 plus years friends. And like anytime I hang out with friends who are like who have a younger friendship relationship than me,
not the younger friendship,
like literally been down since elementary school. Been down since high school, like,
just
so anybody who is, like, younger than the age of our friendship is a new friend to them.
They're new,
y'all. When I hang out with new friends,
listen,
I get shade from tried and true, because.
And it is. I told Kendra yesterday, I'm going to give it to you, but I'm talking junk tomorrow. I'm going to let you have your night.
And then she's going to throw it, especially if you look cute.
I'm going to show you my outfit. What?
Girl, I don't care. You did look cute, though.
You did.
Thank you.
I was like, okay, it's cute. But whatever.
You got to insert the picture.
Look, it's right here. I got to put it right here.
Like, right, have it moving around. Like, just like, oh, this is her. Yeah,
that was me last night.
Afro, pink,
yeah.
Boobs was cute. I said, oh, yeah, it's giving single.
Yes.
Oh my god, so like we was having a conversation last night and and one of my friends who I was out with, OJ, who was also on the podcast, OJ was like, yeah, so you ain't talking to such and such no more, you ain't talking to da 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 no more, so what you gonna do now? I was like, I'm literally just gonna be Kendra,
using my free time to do what I wanna do.
That's it.
That's exactly like, what I'm doing,
not do nobody else.
Exactly. Yeah, I'm just gonna be Kendra right now, and I'm okay with that.
Yeah,
because yeah, I feel like one, both of y'all been telling me for a long time to just
I mean,
look,
I think we've been telling her since the beginning to let that go.
Oh my god, the shade is crazy.
I think everybody's been telling her to let that go, and we're just so excited that she really let it go, because as your friend, like, it was hurting me to watch you be hurt. Like, as your friend, I'm just like, oh, like, I wanted to hear good news so bad, like, as your friend. But I was just like, it's not gonna happen. We just gotta let that go so you can actually be happy.
Yes,
you know,
you're true, right.
And here we are going out in pink dresses on Friday.
After work. At that, then I get home till 5 o'clock Saturday morning.
Not Sex in the City.
Okay. Right. Oh my God.
Kendra in the City. Okay.
Yes.
Listen,
yes.
I'm trying to be involved. Where we going?
Right.
I got a man, but I could be outside.
I could be outside. I just got to plan it.
I just got to plan it. But we'll be outside.
Yeah, we just got to plan it.
Okay, well, y'all just let me know.
Okay.
I feel like y'all do a better job of planning stuff like that. I just be showing up, honestly. Because last night, I didn't even plan that shit. I like literally just sent the money for my ticket and showed up. Like,
we can get something going. Something.
Yeah. I don't be planning. Like, I love
it. There's always something to do.
Yeah. People see me out, and I guess they just think I planned it, because I be like, yeah, I'm out. I'm having fun. But, like.
Right. Because you
just be showing up.
I show up. Like, right. I pay the money, like, in the group chat. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Send me the bill. Tell me what I got to pay.
Right.
Like, I do that. And what date? Okay.
And then you get out there and be the main character. That's why I was like, Kendra, what you got going on? Because this looks like your function.
Oh my God. Every place we walk literally we going to have to put this picture up. The picture got to be up.
Everybody got to see it. Yeah, no.
People was like, is it your birthday? I was like,
you should have said yeah.
Yeah,
it is.
You should have said yeah.
I got free shots.
Exactly.
I saw this one lady, it was my half birthday. She was like, oh. Because I was like, I am an Aquarius, and I was like, my birthday's in January. Mm-hmm. It's literally, yesterday was July 26th. Mm-hmm. So technically, I wasn't wrong because January 25th is my birthday, but okay. I was not out on a Thursday, okay?
Right.
But like, and I was like, yeah, and I'm a Leo rising, and it's Leo season. And she was like, oh. She was like, yes. I was like, girl, it was so funny. Like, and so this older lady, uh-huh. met me in the bathroom.
Yeah.
And she was like, I love your dress so much. And I was like, oh, thank you. I love it too. And she was like, where'd you get it from? I was like, Fashion Nova. And she was like, what is that? I never heard of it.
And she was so serious.
She was
serious.
Yeah, she was.
That's she really wanted you to show her.
For like, sure. She was like, where is it? I was like, it's a website.
And she you have like, money. She have money, because where is it?
Exactly.
She does have money.
Because they're not online shopping.
She got money.
They're not online shopping.
Ma'am.
They're going to boutiques.
Yeah, yeah. You're going to get on Fashion Nova. Yes.
No, she
gonna
girl, right. Download yeah. this app, baby.
You're going to see all them BBLs.
She's going to hop right off.
This is what the young girls are buying.
Right. This isn't quite what I thought it was, but okay.
That right. is what the young girls are
that's
buying.
Exactly.
You know, they be trying to be like us anyway, so she might buy something off that site.
Girl,
yeah,
for she sure. probably going to think she's supporting a small black-owned
she
business.
Is. Like, she probably is. Oh, my God. Oh, baby. Jesus. Oh, baby.
I was like,
what is that? I probably would have died.
Like, is it a store?
No.
You have money.
You should have told her it was at the Underground.
No, because if she would have asked what the Underground was. Because, you know, the Underground is completely different from the Underground
like,
we used to go
yeah,
through.
It is different now. So, yeah, they got, like, yeah, bars and stuff.
They might now. Have been to the Underground now. But when we was going, they ain't that same Underground.
No. I should have just told her it was at Lenox or something like that. She would have went up there looking.
Yeah. Fitz Plaza.
Fitz. I was like, yeah, because yeah. Fitz, yeah. If she can have her go. Choice of wherever she want to go. You just yeah. name that and she can figure it out.
Yeah, I, no, nah, it wasn't it.
She probably would have went to support
so, it was Kendra's birthday. Yesterday. Last night.
But what's period. So funny is, even though y'all don't know Kat, Kat was like, because I was like, what's the vibes? Like, how are we supposed to dress up? And then, I can't stand you.
Dude, I was just looking.
It's only something that I would pick up on because I've known you for your entire life. Please relax. So, anyways, I was like, what's the vibes? You know, like, what are we wearing? OJ was like, oh, it's a speakeasy, da da da. And I'm like, okay, but what's the dress code? And right. then, like, Kat was like, she was like, main character energy. She's like, we the main character when we walk in. Everybody that's there is there for us. I said, oh, say less.
And then you showed up the real main character.
Say less. It's main character. No. We walk in. We're walking in. And we was walking in. Kat was like, okay. She was like, it's main character. She was like, look at them. They all looking at us. I was like, and they are.
I know that's right.
Girl, and no, literally when we walked in, right. she said that shit, and like five dudes like turned their head at the same time. I was like, what kind of witchcraft is this?
I'm trying to tell you.
Like the Barbie pink.
The fro. It was yeah. like, yeah. Okay. It was together.
Everything was, yeah, everything was yeah. given.
The lady
everything.
Was like, our waitress or our server at JoJo's, she was like, it's giving Barbie. Thank you. Yes. She was like, we had a Barbie party here last year. She went through this line. Right. That's what I was about to say. It just be like, mm-hmm. yeah.
Because they can always relate to something that you do because they actually be doing stuff.
Yeah.
I went to a Barbie party last night. Like, what did you hear about this party?
Okay.
Why did I know about it?
Right. Like, I don't ever hear about stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And I mean, JoJo's is having a party today. It's a Western glam party, though, because they're celebrating their 3-year anniversary.
Western glam.
Yeah, but like I literally had to look up on there. Like I always look up if a place has a dress code, and I feel like that's because I'm older now.
Yeah.
So I'm just trying to see. I'm going to your website. Do you have a dress code?
Yeah, because they will for real.
Yeah,
and
I don't
want to
show up in jeans.
You can't. Yeah.
So like, but I do appreciate a place with a dress code in my old age.
Yes. So like that's how you know we getting older.
Oh my
yeah.
god!
That's
yes.
how you know we getting
because it's gonna separate us from
yes. yes. But I like the if I'm gonna go out, I want to dress up. Mm-hmm. That's it.
Cause you are a mom. Yeah, one, you in the gym.
You're not really dressed up.
No,
we wear leggings and
so if I'm going out,
Yes, I'm doing everything. I don't care what the vibe is. I'm going ahead and going to do it.
I don't want to wear my regular uniform. No. Yep, like, I don't want to wear my leggings and my t-shirt.
And your t-shirt,
Like, when I went to Arizona with Courtney, I was out there and I told Courtney, I was like, she was like, well, what do you want to do? I was like, literally, I was like, the only things I want to do is I want to go hiking in Sedona. And I was like, and I want to go to a really nice restaurant with really nice views.
Right,
when I tell you my girl came through.
Because y'all went to the Rock or something.
We went to Point of View. That's literally the name of the restaurant was Point of View.
And this Arizona.
Yeah. Nice.
Courtney came through with that. It literally was so, it was up. Like, we had to drive up this spirally, like, mountain type shit. And, like, we got up there, and the restaurant is, like, inside of the rocks. So, like, it had, like, a lot of stone, like, work and stuff in there. They had, like, this outside patio, so, like, you have to make your reservation. But even if you get there, they still make you wait a little while. And so you go down to the little bar area, sit outside, talk.
Girl, that's cute.
Could see the whole, like, Phoenix.
Yeah, I remember your pictures.
It was really nice. It was like, but they had a strict dress code there. So, like, we had to.
I like those type of places.
Me too.
Girl, what? I told Courtney, I said, oh, this Big Daddy energy. What you doing? Talking about you. Girl, I was like, hold on. Barely had to pick up my wallet. What's going on, girl? We had a good time though, and the food was so
that's good.
Oh my god, I had never had pork belly until I went there.
Oh my god, it was so good.
And Courtney is probably gonna hear this and laugh because I talked about it for like 3 days after.
It was good.
Yeah. Like thinking of it right now, it was so good. Yeah, and I think, like, taking it back to motherhood, though, like, you have to give yourself that free time to, like, experience things like that. Because you literally will be with your kid, like, all the time. And, like, I feel like how you get mom guilt, but then, like, the older they got, and, like, I was just like.
And now they can talk.
Hey, I'm gonna holler at y'all boys. Like, I'm about to go out. Oh, you're going out? Yeah. Where are you going? What are you coming back? Hey.
Not you got these grown men.
It's that ancestor that lives inside of us.
Do I need to stay up?
Do I need to be up? You got your key. You gonna be able to get out?
Exactly. He's like, he's like, am I gonna see you in the morning? Like, I ain't never not came home like that. What are you talking about? Like,
kids are so dramatic. Am I gonna see you when I wake up?
No, for real.
I used to ask me that. Am I gonna see you when I wake up?
Who else gonna be here? Are you coming back? I'm coming back. I don't know where I'm supposed to go after. I'm coming back. This is where I live. I live here. I literally live here. My step is here.
My stuff is here. These kids are something different. I think they really are. Being stay at home,
I think by the time I got to Zara, my third child, the mom get left. I was like, I need to go.
Yeah.
I need to go do something. Like, obviously, I'm going to come back. And I'm just very grateful that I have a husband who is a good husband and be like, go ahead. They good. I'm here. Like, yeah, you right. I used to have a little anxiety. Like, because in my head, I'm like, okay, he's been working all day. Like, he's also tired. I'm tired. But he's never made me feel bad for that. He's like, nah. Go to the gym. Like, we good. Like,
that's good, though.
Yeah,
that's
he literally good. Be I like, love that for you. You gonna go to the gym? I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna go.
Girl,
okay.
He's not like Greg. I'll be like, yeah. Leave me alone.
He be asking me. He'll be like, well, it's almost 7. You going?
You still here?
You put my shoes on. My bad.
What is we doing?
Right, he be like, they're fine. Like, and they are. Like, they eat dinner when I come home. He's already giving them a bath. They're already, like, ready to lay down for bed. I come home, eat dinner, you know, catch my shower, and then they sleep.
Yeah.
So, I'm like, oh, thank God, because.
Yeah. That's a real husband, though. You know what I'm saying? That's a real man.
Yeah, like, that's like a real partner. That's literally a real partnership. Like, people talk about this 50-50. Like, Quinn say all the time, like, we do 100-100.
Yeah.
Like, man. You know what I'm saying? Because it's just not financial. Like, yeah, he the one works, but, like, the other half wouldn't run without me. I don't care.
Right. That's true.
I don't care how much
and
he works.
That's true.
He cannot come home and have the house together. When I say together, everything. Not just cleaning. Yeah. Like, I run everything. Mm-hmm. And people don't realize that because they think, oh, he make the money. The man supposed to be this. And he's always going to be the man. He's always going to be at the top, at the head. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, he's okay with his masculinity to understand, like, my wife really hold it down.
Yeah.
And I'm glad that we understand each other on that part. So when it's time for me to, I'm just going to get a pedicure. Okay, cool. When you going? Okay, cool. If he need to go somewhere, he'll just take the kids with him. It's not like a, oh, if I go, he going to be this. He going to be mad because I dealt with that.
Yeah.
Oh, why are you going? Why are you leaving? Like, damn, it's going to
work out. Yeah. Right. I like that, though, because I seen something. It might have been like a somebody older. Mm-hmm. I think it was on social media. He's the head, but you the neck.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, you going to make the shit
like,
shake.
You have to, you have to understand that, like, when you get in a relationship, especially a marriage, because people, like me and Kendra talked about last time, like, social media is really killing this relationship thing. And it's just like, just because someone comes online and saying something, oh, my God, so can we just cut it out?
Or the what do you bring to the table?
Oh, baby. My God. Like, y'all not tired?
We've
been doing this since the pandemic. Y'all not tired of talking about that?
The table. You know what?
You know what? Don't worry about it.
I'm good. Love and joy.
This purse. That's what I'm wearing. Like, I don't know what you want me to say. I'm bringing me.
I brought myself here.
Exactly. I'm not about to sit here and give you a list of everything that I'm bringing. I'm bringing me. And I know what I bring to the table.
Right.
I know. What are you bringing?
First of all, don't ask me what I bring to the table.
Don't.
You ain't pick me up for the date.
Don't.
I mean, if you ain't pick me up for the date, don't ask me.
Because I drove my own car and put my gas in.
I drove myself here. I put gas in my car. I opened the door to my, like, to get in. Mm-hmm. I told them I was here. Like, we didn't, like, come on.
No, we not having that. 50-50, or bring myself to the table.
For real. If we gonna be anything, we need to be for real.
If we gonna be anything,
be for real.
Because we have not been for real since the pandemic.
Girl,
since the pandemic, let's talk about something else. Let's talk about the books y'all like. What books y'all reading?
Right. What
books
are you reading?
Because y'all not reading, that's why.
Right. I want to start a book club. That has nothing to do. What? It does bring, come back
to
free
time. Me and Kendra talked about that.
I want to do a book club.
I was like, I'm going to do that at my house. Kendra's like, don't have people in your house.
Don't have people in your house. Don't have them people in your house.
And I'm that type of person. I don't like...
If it's friends, yes.
What? Yeah, now,
if it's friends, yes. But if it's going to be like a world book club...
Oh, no. I'm not having new friends at my house.
Three brown girls book club.
Right.
Three brown girls.
We just came up with something.
We'll be back. We'll be back on that one.
We'll check back in
next season on that
one. We'll circle back. We can circle back.
We definitely can circle.
That could definitely be a thing.
Yeah. Now that I'm thinking about it.
But y'all don't like this type of stuff. I like to.
I like the fantasy.
All types of stuff.
I like fantasy because self-help books are cool, but they're just kind of boring. I know I'm going to have people. I have a lot of people that disagree because my husband is self-help book. He reads them. Yes, he loves them. But they're just kind of boring to me. But they're just kind of boring. I like the fantasy. I like to get away and imagine what I think this person looks like. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Acts like, talks like. Like, I like to get away when I'm reading. That's why I like pages. So, like,
I'm laughing because when I first started reading, like, I would read like the urban, like, teen books, and then I got put on to Zane, like, urban erotica. That's all I knew for the longest time. And then when I went on deployment in 21, this Caucasian girl gave me a murder mystery book, and I fell in love. I was like, oh, and I can't remember the author for nothing, but the book was good. That's all I remember. It was really good. So, like, I definitely want to get into other genres of books.
Yeah.
I'm like, that's all I've grown up on was urban books.
I remember the Zane era.
You used to read them, too.
A girl.
I think you were reading Coldest Winter before I read Coldest Winter.
Like, in 24 hours, I would stay up, like, it was like a winter break or something. I'd just sit there and read the book till the next morning and the sun coming out. Like, that's how
I had that with the 50 Shades of Grey book. I read all three in a
week. Same.
But they're so good. Because everybody was like, oh, it's soft porn, but it's not. To me, it was a love story. Mm-hmm. That's just me, though.
I haven't
even watched the movies to that one.
I mean, the movies are good, but like, the book, to me, it was a love story. Of course, it got the adult stuff, but not too much like Zane. Like, Zane's going to make you picture all of it.
Yeah.
50 Shades of Grey.
Not all of it.
Zane's going to make you picture all of it. But like 50 Shades of Grey, I feel like it was more of a story because it, you know, it introduced the characters, something about their lives, and like it felt like more like real people.
Okay.
Like, okay, college student meeting this person. Mm-hmm. And, like, I thought they were good. Mm-hmm. And I read all three in a week. Like, sun up, like, Kyle, like, waking like, oh, it's night outside.
Let's read.
I
need to go to school. Exactly.
I don't like none of them kind. All I do is read the fantasy books. Literally, I read, you know, I've been reading, I read all the A Court of Thorns and Roses series, that series, mm-hmm. and I'm still reading her Throne of Glass series because I have the tandem read. That's where I am in that. For the people who know, they know. I'm in the tandem read, which is when you're reading the two. There are two stories. There are two books in there. Where the timeline, look.
I know tandem and two.
Where the timeline, yeah.
I know what it means, but I was just like,
I know there are double two something.
Separate books in that series, but the events are happening on the same timeline, but they're just two separate books. So people have suggested that you read it both together. Of them together.
Okay,
so
okay.
like they divided, there's like this whole thing where they divided them up on TikTok.
Oh, like you should read this
like,
chapter,
okay,
this
okay.
chapter, you read from this chapter, and this book, then you switch to this book. Then
yeah,
you,
that's okay. how I am. Book Talk got me right now.
Yeah.
I'm on
in a chokehold.
Randomly,
in
out of nowhere, I'm on Book Talk.
Yeah,
I don't know, but I've been saving people.
Man.
I've been saving people.
Oh, my
like,
God.
Okay, I need to start reading these.
The way my Amazon cart look right now with all these books.
And I'm a physical book reader.
Me too. I like to turn the page, yeah.
But Ken told me about audiobooks. I'm like,
I don't like audio. That's what Kendra was trying to, I don't like audio.
I like to
turn the page, yeah.
I be so busy moving all the time. I feel like I'm always moving around. Dog, literally, so my battery died in my car, totally off topic, but kind of on topic. My battery died in my car like last week, and I was at work. I didn't know what's going on. I feel like every time the battery dies in my car, I never know what's going on with the car. I'm always like, oh my God, something's happening.
It'd be the battery.
It'd be the battery. The lights be coming on and the car won't turn. It'd be like, click, click, click. I'm like, oh my God.
Anytime you hit a click, it's the battery.
It's the battery.
Anytime it clicks,
it's the battery. Look, it's just so silly.
Oh my God.
And so I'm like, I was on my break at work and I was in the car and I was like, I can't roll the windows up. And I was like, wait, I have AAA. Where's my AAA card? Dog, my AAA card is at home. I'm texting my mom. I'm like, Mom. That was just the out, please.
Kendra's like, Callie, I almost called you.
I almost called her. Because like, I was like, I don't know what to do. My mom was like, luckily her and David were home. So she was like, girl, send me the address.
Right. Everybody
David,
cool.
This rat be so calm.
Yes.
She's like, oh,
she's
my God.
Over Kendra. Girl, where you at? Where are you?
First of all, she raised me. I always been the most dramatic. Student. I ain't going to lie to you. I always been the most dramatic. And they knew it. I think I'm probably the most dramatic sibling, cousin, like, family member. Like...
All of the above.
Friend, like, she always has a story. Like, what is going on with her? But yeah, so they pulled up to the job, got my keys. David changed the battery. He tested it and changed it in the parking lot. I think he already knew it was the battery when he pulled up.
Right. Yeah.
He already knew. But my mom was like, because I was like, I literally just got a battery in my car. I feel like my battery died. So like, I had got the battery. It's been about 3 years, almost. It's like 2.5 years because I saved the paperwork.
Mm-hmm. Usually it's a sticker on the battery and it tells you the month and the year that you bought it. Just
you can tell her
girl,
man.
I was just about to ask, how do you know this?
Because I'm like, I ain't never
heard
of
it. Yeah, uses.
I don't know.
Right.
Yeah, good
it's
to
a
know.
Little circle
good
sticker.
To know. Wow. Okay. Now that I know that. But so anyways, my mom was like, well, you need to look and see if it's a warranty on there. You know what I'm saying? You go take it and they can give you another battery or whatever, something. I don't know, whatever they do with warranties. And then I was like, yeah. And then she was like, what was your mileage when you got the new battery? And I was like, I think it was 30,000 miles when I got it, I got the new battery. I currently have 89,000 miles on my car.
Yeah, my girl, you be on the road.
My mom was like, Kendra, that's 50,000 miles. She was like, where have you been driving?
I'm a mother.
I don't know. I be in the car just with the kids. I do be driving a lot, though.
Yeah.
It's all
same.
That Jonesboro in Atlanta. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It's all that Jonesboro downtown.
Yeah.
So I don't know where I be at.
Yeah.
I know. Because as a seasoned friend,
as a seasoned,
I have our location.
Yes. Oh, I don't even have our location. And I've known you for...
Not looking at your one hand, girl. You're going to have to look at, three hands.
Got all our toes.
Right, you got these my hands in.
But no.
It's okay.
That's exactly what it is.
We going to get the location of the car.
That's
I don't
exactly
have her location.
You didn't have girl, my location. I don't be nowhere but the house. And maybe y'all started inviting me places. There it is. Bam, you didn't know where I was at.
Kendra would call me and be like,
at home.
It says you've been at home all day.
Yeah. Yeah, that's
right. When I be seeing that she be at home, I be looking. But then when you be in Fayetteville, I be like,
what you doing in Fayetteville?
I grocery shop in Fayetteville and Peachtree City because I refuse to do anything in Lovejoy. If you know, you know.
Yeah. I mean, if you know, and I'm over here like, I go to that Walmart all the time. It's I ain't never seen the ghetto shit that happened.
I had the Walmart over there. Yeah, I've heard about it, but I haven't seen it. But I just feel like it's going to be that one time I decided to bring all my three kids in there by myself. And I'm going to be like, why are y'all doing this? Mm-mm. So I drive to Peachtree City.
I feel it. I used to go to the Fayetteville. Because I be having more stuff.
Yes, and that's it's stuff in Peachtree City Walmart that I've never seen at Lovejoy. And I'm like, but y'all the same company. Yes, Peachtree City keep it stocked. Product about to fall off the shelf. It's so stocked.
I need to go out there.
Yes.
Because they don't be having nothing at Walmart.
Everybody just so happy. Thank you. Have a great day. Hey, you too, girl.
Them girls be looking
so girl. Right. Like, you upset because you applied for this job.
I'm sorry they making everything self-checkout.
Hey, you got to talk to, what's his name? Sam Walton. Ain't that the owner of Walmart and Sam's?
I think so, yeah.
Y'all gonna have to talk to him and his folks.
Well, shoot, at Sam's, you know, I'm not just scanning.
Oh, yes.
I'm a scanning girl. Listen, because I'm going to look at y'all like,
bruh, be getting so mad.
Bruh,
be
getting so mad.
And they be looking at me like,
yeah, I already paid. Scan my thing.
They be looking so mad, but they sitting in that line. Baby, you got the same
thing. The line is all the way to the back of the store. Why would I stay here with y'all? I have an app.
Even, but you know you can do it for the pizza and stuff too.
Yes,
girl, I mean,
yes, Kendra. I walk in and I order, and when we get done,
they
be so mad. The line be so long. They be like, and you walk up, online order. Yeah.
Thank you, give my stuff. Yes, ma'am.
And then all my groceries are paid for, and they stand in that line. They're standing this food line, and my kids finna sit here and eat this slice of pizza because
that
part of free time.
Yes,
I'm not using the standing line.
I'm not standing.
Sam is ridiculous. And then it's not like Walmart. Like Walmart has like a scan and go thing, but you have to pay for their membership. Like Sam's, you have to be a member, so it's just included.
Yeah,
Walmart. First of all, the fact that I can't tap my phone.
That Apple Pay? Oh, my God.
Bruh, I be out here on the hope and a prayer that places take Apple Pay because I never usually have my wallet. I'm always like, y'all got Apple Pay?
Right.
Well, I stay with my wallet, but I always forget about Apple Pay. I'm not going to lie. And Greg be getting mad at me. He's like, Kai, use your phone. Man,
that's point. At the ATM, he be like, why don't you use your phone? Look,
you
I forgot.
Do it.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I didn't even know you can do that.
If you save your debit card to your wallet, like Apple Pay, you go to the ATM, put your phone up,
and I be trying to put my chip on that thing, so it's only for the phone.
Oh, my God. It says phone, Kai.
No, because, like, what Navy fed, they...
Kai, it says phone.
Girl, what?
But I get it. In your defense, it is those three lines, like, when
yeah,
you tap it.
Like, yes,
it's for your phone, Kai. It's for your phone.
Oh, it's
okay. So, today we learned that the battery got the sticker on it. You can use your phone at the ATM. It's a couple things to take away from today.
Oh, my God. I'm over here dying laughing because I'm just... I be up there like, bro, this shit's so stupid. Why do you even got this thing?
You be mad. Whole time it's you.
Whole time it's you.
I be at the damn ATM cursing. Like, why the hell did they even have this? Sitting here, but I gotta put my damn card. I'm so mad.
If they
I gotta call corporate.
Because as a member.
And corporate gonna be like, are you crazy?
Where are you? What location are you in? I don't know.
What branch are you
right.
in?
Oh my God.
Oh my God. That's hilarious.
Yes. Oh my
goodness.
Phone.
Damn,
I'm
sorry. You know you're getting old, huh?
Using my free time wrong.
Using the free time wrong. Use your free time to get mad at an ATM when you're doing it wrong.
Get yourself together, ma'am.
Please.
Use TikTok.
Right.
Because that's the new
girl,
Google.
It is.
That's why they told to shut it down.
Listen, last night I randomly decided, like, while we was out, I think we were standing somewhere. I don't know. I was standing somewhere for too long. My mind started wandering. And I decided to Google, I saw a picture of Angel Reese and Tyla, the singer.
Mm-hmm.
I decided to Google their heights.
Angel's 6'3".
She's 6'3", and Tyla's 5'3". Because I looked at the picture, and I was like,
damn, she little. Because then she took a picture next to LeBron or something like that.
Yeah.
I was like, oh. Wow.
That's how I feel when I stand next to my
That
friends.
Was random.
Oh.
You're not that tall.
Not as She's, much taller than you.
She was talking to me. It was a little.
Like, me and Kendra gym pictures are the funniest thing to me.
Yeah,
oh, my God.
Yeah.
People be like, oh, my God, are you really that tall?
You're tall.
She's
Callie
little.
Is tall in real life.
She's little.
Like, literally, if, like, a man tell you he, like, that's how I know dudes be lying when they be like, they 6 foot. I be like.
Because I got a friend
I have a friend that's 5'11", and it's a woman, and women don't lie about their height. And you're not taller than her. Mm-mm. You're not taller than her.
Right.
You're probably 5'7", bro. Like, and
it's
okay.
You're 5'7" on a good day.
You're on a good day.
Probably got platforms on right now.
Period. You got them little things inside your shoes.
They're going to
look exactly. You're not 6 foot.
No, and it's okay, guys. Everybody's not tall. It's fine. Men. That wasn't for you. Men.
It was a little...
That wasn't for you.
First of all, and they just need to relax on lying about their height. Everybody don't have to be tall. Like, literally.
In y'all free time, find something else to do besides lie about your height.
Right. Find something else to do besides lie.
Besides going on podcasts and talking shit.
Oh, my God.
I'm just saying. Because we know it'd be the men. With this 50-50 conversation.
Oh, my God.
And the table conversation. We're done there.
And then y'all be single.
That's what make it with a receding hairline.
Oh, my God. That's what make it worse. Because y'all are single. Talk about single things. Talk about single things.
The girls came to eat today. Well, friends, I think we good.
Yeah.
Would we say 3 Brown Girls book club? We gotta find a book, though, because me, personally, I have to see. I don't want to read no Zane book.
We not reading. No, we not reading Zane. Kyle was saying that was just the era.
We're gonna do
era.
But we're wanna... No.
Uh-oh. She like.
We're gonna do multiple. We're gonna do. We're gonna do different genres of books, Ken. So you have to come up out your comfort zone.
I know. I do be stuck in.
Come on.
Yeah, I mean, we could try.
Like we could try. We could just read one.
Because I'm into my trying things era, too. Because that's how you know what you like. I mean, of course, you know what you like, but you might find something else like, oh, that was actually a pretty good book. You know what I mean? You just got to switch your whole, you know, just like, okay, I read this book about this, and, you know, I might like it.
That's true. Just imagine, like, you thought I was going to be the girl who wanted to go out, but really, I want to read.
Stop
it. If I ever meet a dude who likes to read and is like, yes, let's read the same book together, I don't know what I would do with myself.
Man.
Y'all have more to talk about and everything. Y'all should have
Did you get to chapter 3? Did you see what? Yeah, I can only imagine. Yeah.
I don't know what I would do with myself. But
Girl, go to the bookstore.
I'd be at the bookstore, but mostly be kids in there, you know what I'm saying?
What books are you be going to?
Barnes & Noble.
Oh.
Because they had a kids section. I think it's because I go up there to the kids section because I also do like children's books a lot and I'm always building. I have a huge children's books collection. So
I do too.
Yeah. I mean, and it's, I don't know if it's like the mom, the teacher, who it is that loves those books, but I love
That's all about because
I be wanting my kids to read them.
I just keep them like, I just have them.
Yeah.
And everywhere I go, I'm picking up a book from kids. Never have enough books.
I don't get that conversation because I definitely be like, no, they can always have
them. Yeah, my kids' doctors give them books at their appointments. Okay. You know, Zara's going like every 3 months now, so we always getting books.
That's nice. That's a nice doctor.
They go to Kaiser. They have female black doctor, love them. Like, they take care of my babies. I like how they remember now. We come in, they're like, hey, Zara.
Takeaways from today.
Takeaways.
Car battery.
Check your car battery. Check that sticker. To see when you bought it. Car batteries usually last about 3 years. If it's been over 3 years, you're probably about to need a battery.
Okay.
I will go ahead.
If
you have a warranty on your battery, you can go take it back to the store, and they'll give you a core price for it. And it might be free.
I did not know that.
I didn't know none of that.
That's what the
I'm
going
to start calling Callie.
Literally, that's what I said.
What am I supposed to be doing here?
So the takeaways from today's episode are your car battery has a sticker on it with the year, right?
Yeah, the year that you bought it.
Yes. You can use your phone at the ATM.
Yeah, you can do that.
And lastly, as a parent, prioritize your time. Prioritize your time so that you can have your free time. And I think that wraps up the first season of Single Mama Minimal Drama. Yay!